above 300 in the entire evolution of humanity. For over 3 million years, it's never gone above 300. But we're in a completely different climate chemistry right now in terms of CO2. So, there's an organization called 350.org, and their objective is to raise awareness about this, because scientists have said that 350 parts per million is the highest number we can be at and not have catastrophic consequences. So they're saying we can't go above this, but we already went above it. We went above it in 1988. And so the whole purpose of this organization, 350.org, is to raise awareness so we have to go back down. And so their symbol is sort of, it's sort of like this, 350, with this arrow pointing down. And this is a global movement, and I would say right now it's probably the biggest global movement there is. Building soils, doing what you're doing, is the number one way that we can get this number down. All of the attention in the world is geared toward trying to reduce the amount of carbon we put in the air. So less fossil fuels, less cars, you know, less coal. That's all about what's called the source. They want to reduce the amount we're putting in the air, which is a good thing. But what we're doing here is about the sink. But what's going to inhale it? What's going to pull it out of the air? What's going to actually make it go down? And that's called the sink. And that's where soils come in, and that's where healthy soils come in, because grasslands cover 2/3 of the world, of the landed surface of the world. So it's important for us to have solidarity with this organization and with the climate change movement. If we could get the climate change community to understand that the work we do here is this arrow, and that was Huggins, I have to credit you with that. That'll be huge, because the climate change community is where the world is sort of, where the world is thinking these days. And if they can realize, oh, here's a solution. Consider this CO2 in the atmosphere. So the faucet is everything that's going in. Fossil fuels being burned. But it's also fire. And fires contribute heavily to this. So fires contribute to the CO2 going in, but they also deplete the soil, which means they make the drain smaller. When you use fire as a land management practice, you're increasing the amount of CO2 that goes in the atmosphere, and you're decreasing the capacity of the soil to suck it out. Okay. The role of livestock is to, I wasn't prepared for this, is to clear the grass so you don't need fire. So you're reducing the need for fire, and you're making the soil healthier, so you're expanding the sink so that more can come down. So they're reducing the source and expanding the sink.
So what are the two things that put the most carbon into the air from most of the world's land? Fire and? Too few animals wandering around. Donkeys, goats wandering around, and fire. And how much fire burns in Africa? Over 2 billion acres every year.
So the idea was that we would get another picture today with everyone, and I guess we just need to wait for the G-Wave.
She's here.
Oh, is she here?
Yeah.
Oh, all right.
Switch! Switch out! Go on. And straight toward me.
Cheese, everyone. Hold up your 350 sign. Cheese, everyone. Big smile. Cheese, cheese. Get those 350 signs so I can see them really well. Really well. Oh,
350 parts per million. I really believe that as the Africa Center for Holistic Management, we need to work towards coming back to that figure of 350. There are many reasons for that. It will sustain our own way of living, but more than that, we believe that it is possible to go back to that figure. As we tie down more carbon into the soil, and also as we demonstrate that we should not be responding to global warming by mitigating it, but actually by changing, so that at least we arrive at the points 350. It is possible to do it. Sodomo ipase korowani makamotari rasei.